you don't want to have a FAIRMAP, the question is, how do you actually go and do it, right? I think it's important for people to understand that this is actually something that people go out and intentionally do. They're not just getting lucky, right? They're thinking about how people are organized when they're trying to misalign seats and votes, and use this concept of packing and cracking. So when one party gains control of the process, and at the end we'll talk a little bit how to change the process, when one party gains control of the process, what they do is they pack as many of the other party's adherents into as few districts as possible. And they give those districts huge majorities, right? So if there's 99 districts, there's no mathematical way for one party to gain control of all 99 districts, right? The goal is to get as many as they can. But their goal is to get 60 or 70, right? Their goal isn't to get 80 or 90, because that would be mathematically impossible unless you start killing off adherents of the other party, which we can, even they haven't gone that far. So you get big wins for the losing party. Does that make sense? Big wins for the losing party, but just in a handful of districts. And then you take the rest of their supporters and you crack them into districts, you spread them out so that they can't win in those seats. Let me visually illustrate this. So over here we have, and for purposes of the illustration, we only have 64 people living in this state. In four districts, there are 32 purple party adherents and 32 neon green party adherents. And they're distributed around the state, and if you draw simple lines, you can put essentially 8 people from each of the two parties in each of those four districts. Now what happens in here is that elections become really meaningful, because some of these people feel really strongly in their partisan identification, and some of them less so. Some of those people lean one way, but they're really swing voters. So what happens in this district is the purple candidate is a really good candidate. They're smart, they're articulate, they work really hard, they raise money, they knock on doors, and they convince a couple of these neon green party adherents to vote for them. And the purple party candidate wins in this district. But in this district, the neon green candidate is stronger, and they run a better campaign, and they're smarter, and they're more experienced, so they win. And so in each district, the election itself matters. Going out there and getting the votes and having democracy actually take place makes a difference. But if you gerrymander the map, if you draw the lines in such a way that you pack as many green, neon green party adherents into this district as possible, we have 14 out of the 16 people in this district are neon green. This neon green candidate could be a total idiot. This neon green candidate could have no connection to the community. They don't even have to shower. But they're going to win, because they're not going to convince enough, the purple candidate's not going to convince enough people to cross over from their partisan identification. But then in these districts, these three districts, the purple candidate doesn't have to be the stronger candidate. They've got their party pretty well outnumbered. And so even if one of them crosses over, the purple candidate in these three districts is going to win. This map, I don't care what happens in the election. I don't care how much money they raise, how many doors they knock on, how smart they are, what their agenda is, how attractive they are to the electorate. I will tell you that in this election, three purple candidates are going to win and one green candidate is going to win. And this, right here, is what happened in Wisconsin. That's what they did. They just drew the lines in such a way, and they put all the Democrats in as few districts as they could, right, about 34 of them, and they put all the Republicans with less majorities, but still strong and safe majorities, in the other two-thirds of the seats, right? And they did it in the Assembly, and they did it in the Senate in 2011. So the majorities in Wisconsin have no hope of winning the majority, even if they get more votes, which is what happened in 2012. And that has a dampening effect, a chilling effect on candidates, on volunteers, on donors. What the other side says is, well, you're right, the Democrats got more votes in 2012, but it doesn't matter because the Republicans got more votes in 2014. That's what they say. It doesn't matter. They didn't keep winning. Well, don't you think that if this was the result, that maybe the Democrats did a little less well here because they weren't able to raise the money, they weren't able to get the candidates, they weren't gonna win. There's nothing they could do. There was no mathematical path to victory. In fact, and I'll say this again later, they could have won, mathematically, the biggest electoral victory in Wisconsin history, and they still wouldn't have even gotten 40 seats, even with the biggest victory. More votes than they'd ever gotten before. So that also protects incumbents, right? And the incumbent party is protected. And we're, I'm gonna skip the story. What really happens is that the legislators end up then playing to the extremes. And they do that on both sides. Democratic candidates play to the extremes of the Democratic Party, and the Republican candidates play to the extremes of the Republican Party. And what's happened in Wisconsin is almost every moderate politician, and there used to be many in the legislature from both sides, they're all gone. They're all retired or defeated. If I don't know how many of you are from Milwaukee County, I know we're right over the border in Ozaukee County, but in Milwaukee County, one by one, every moderate Democrat in the legislature got picked off. Every single one of them. Now, I'll be honest with you, I'm a liberal Democrat. My organization is co-chaired by a Republican and a Democrat, and in a lot of those primary elections, I supported the progressive candidate. I supported the candidate that was more to the extreme, because the system gave me a chance of winning, right? They've drawn these districts in such a way that the advantage was to the more extreme candidates.